It's a fantastic achievement. It's taken 3 years of long, hard work in fundraising and getting grants bids in, but it's a fantastic achievement. £65,000 worth of new bus, and we couldn't be happier to coincide with our 50th anniversary year. It's just a fantastic present to ourselves.
It's a constant process, I guess, with the transport service. Does the fund start all over again now?
It certainly does, and the thing that will contribute first to that fund is actually the sale of the bus that Clover has come to replace. So we'll be selling Iris, and hopefully that will kickstart the fund for the next one, because it is, as you said, a continual process. Got a fleet of five, you've got to think about how you replace them. We're doing lots of shoppers, lots of outings, and those are in great demand. We always have room for more passengers, so if anyone wants to register with us, it's a fantastic opportunity just to give the office a ring and we can send you a pack out through the post. But yeah, we do regular shoppers and outings, and they will continue for a long time to come.
It's very good. We've got a fairly modern fleet now. Very good to have new vehicles, ones which will be reliable, very comfortable to sit in and use, because it's the comfort for the passengers that's the most important thing, and that's the most important thing about the driving as well. Having gone through the Midas driving scheme, that's one thing that's really stuck with me, is giving people a comfortable, safe ride.
50 years ago when you were part of the team that set up Beverley Community Lift as it now is, this is the world away from what you planned, isn't it?
It is very different. We were a very different organisation initially for the first 4 or 5 years, providing a very varied range of services as well. We were presented with a vehicle in 1974 initially, and I do remember asking a silly question, it seems now, what on earth do we want a minibus for? But at our peak we had 9 different vehicles, not all based in Beverley, one or two were based in local villages as well. But to have enough work to do to keep 9 vehicles occupied just shows how much we've developed and what a strong need there is for transport, especially in the rural areas, and especially for people who haven't got their own transport or haven't got members of their family living locally, or have disabilities or mobility issues. It's a really valuable service.